Thank you. The correlation. this equation for this ordinary equation for h plus minus p. And this is a very simple equation. And if we, you introduce a new variable s by this, this means the singularity of this equation small s is corresponding to this one. So y plus small s, and this gamma 1 half appears from this part for j equals 0. And so and by the definition of our s, this is this is confusing. This s and that s is different. So somewhat related but different. So somewhat confusing. You can understand. And anyway, C plus B has this form. On the other hand, U5 is a standard basis. One of the standard U5 is this one. Independent solution of hypergeometric equation. U5 has some power function. Just the power 1 minus gamma. And here gamma is 3/2. So U5 has this form. Now we compare this part to this one. So C plus B has square root similarity at the origin. And there is no homomorphic part. And U5 is also such a form. And we observe that C plus B is a linear combination of U1 and U5, and the coefficients is C1 and C2. So there is no homomorphic part, and so C1 should be vanished. And comparing the leading coefficient, we can evaluate the value of C2. Clearly, we observe that the Fourier transform of C minus has this form. By using the same argument, we can conclude that here we should use another independent solution, U6. This is a there are three regular singularities of the hypergeometric equation. minus B. First compound expressed by geometric function. Here. So from this formula, originally psi plus B is defined near s equals 0. And on s equals 0, there is a third type singularity. And c minus, this is this has a singularity at in the original variable, s equals 0 and 1. And this is corresponding to minus and so the WKB solution of C plus B has a singularity here, and also it has a singularity here. And the singular part is given by this C minus. So probably this should be minus plus. Anyway, thus we have